Hi guys, Aris, How to the Bastards. The big question. Is it worth getting an 8X version 3 PSU now? Everyone has been asking me lately why I should bother buying an 8X version 3 PSU when the 8X version 3.1 specification is out. This is because they cannot understand that the main difference between these two specs is just a PCB header on the PSU's modular panel, which is super easy to replace. I have already written many details about the new and previous 8X specs, which you will find in the links of which I will provide in the video's description, but I will make things easier for you to understand in today's video. Short reply. Actually, many 8X version 3 PSUs already have a 12V 2x6 header instead of the 12V HPWR one. They don't advertise that for some reasons. Any old stock left will not be sold if the product has been revised or if it advertises that it is 8X version 3.1 instead of version 3. The cost of changing the packaging, marketing material and all relevant material is high enough to make them wait for the right time to make the change. The connecting cable now is exactly the same. This is another detail that most users are unaware. Guys, the cable remains the same. There is no change to the cable connecting the PSU's 12 plus 4 pin or 2x8 pins to the graphics card corresponding header. To provide you with the complete picture here, there's one difference actually. The name is KIM. Instead of 12V HPWR cable, it is now called 12V 2x6 cable. I know, it's crazy. 8X version 3.1 statement now about the 12 plus 4 pin header on the PSU. This is a part of the 8X version 3.1 spec, clearly stating that the 12V 2x6 PCB header is optional for modular PSUs. The same applies to non-modular PSUs, of course, where the high power cable is soldered to the PSU's PCB directly. And another thing, which actually makes matters even worse for potential buyers, with the only exception of the 12V 2x6 header, for PSUs that have it, since Intel, as I've already mentioned, doesn't make it clear whether the PSU should have it or not, the 8X version 3.1 spec is looser than the 8X version 3 in hold-up time, since it allows for only 12 milliseconds of hold-up time. In comparison, the 8X version 3 sets a minimum of 17 milliseconds. Can I please have or get an 8X spec with a 12V 2x6 header and 17 milliseconds hold-up time? Because I'm not a big fan of what Intel did to actually make the new specification more relaxed. The PSU PCB header, old or new one? And does it actually matter? In most cases where melted connectors were reported, the problems were on the graphics card, not the power supply. This is because it is difficult not to connect correctly the 12V HPWR or 12V 2x6 cable on the PSU, which, you know, the PSU is stable, it's more rigid than the graphics card, which can have some movement, especially if the chassis doesn't have a GPU anti-sagging mechanism. So it's kind of hard not to fully connect the cable on the PSU. To wrap up, for all reasons which I've mentioned already, I believe I made clear the following things. Changing an 8X version 3 PSU to an 8X version 3.1 only involves the change of the 12 plus 4 pin header to the new one, given that the PSU already has one, it uses one. If a PSU uses 2x8 pin headers on its modular board to power the high power cable, it is automatically 8X version 3.1 compliant, provided it follows the rest of the requirements. PSUs with native 12V HPWR or 12V 2x6 cables can be 8X version 3.1 compliant if they already meet the 8X version 3.0 spec. 8X version 3.1 PSUs allow for a lower hold-up time, 12 milliseconds instead of 70 milliseconds in 8X version 3, which in my opinion is a big step backward. ATX version 3.1 PSUs are not ATX version 3 compliant because of the lower hold-up time. This is the first time for the ATX spec where a newer spec does not cover the previous one in all aspects. There can be ATX version 3.1 PSUs without the 12-volt 2x6 connectors. And actually, there also can be ATX version 3 PSUs without it, which have lower transient response requirements, 150% peak instead of 200%. You can read the full article on hwbusters.com, and remember, before investing in a new power supply, you should read my best ATX version 3.x PSUs article on hwbusters to decide which suits your needs better. If you want to support us, you have a Patreon page, we have a Discord server if you want to come in direct contact with us, and that's all. Bye bye.